Let's rejoin the conversation on the Richard Syrett Show on News Talk Sauga 960 AM.
Hey, welcome back. Today we commemorate Yom Hashoah, or Holocaust Remembrance Day, and we remember the 6 million victims murdered by Nazi Germany and their collaborators. And Michael Mostyn is CEO of B'nai B'rith Canada, and he joins me now. Hello, Michael. Welcome.
Hi. Thank you for having me on today.
My pleasure. Now, as I understand it, it's not only a remembrance of the 6 million Jews that were murdered by the Nazis, but it also commemorates the valiant efforts and the resistance of Jews that fought back and resisted both peacefully and, you know, more aggressively in places like the Warsaw Ghetto, correct?
Well, that's absolutely correct. I mean, it's really recalling the Nazi atrocities, those who perished, those who survived. And there were many ways that people survived. You know, the instant thing that we think about are the concentration camps, the images, the horror of those concentration camps, and thankfully some did survive. The Nazis were not successful in their goal of wiping out the Jewish people, but of course there were some uprisings, such as the Warsaw Ghetto uprising. There were also partisans who lived through the war in the forest, fighting and killing Nazis on some occasions. So, for every life there was a different story.
Right, and there are also Jews that escaped from various places under Nazi control and went on to fight in resistance groups and for, I guess, the Allies, correct?
Sure. I mean, that did happen from time to time. There were Jews that, you know, that were running away and the war came to them, you know, as the Nazi machine was rolling its way through Europe. It was one of those stories that people didn't know how it was starting and beginning and ending, just a real time of chaos.
I want to go back to 2019. There was a survey or a poll done. It was called the Holocaust Knowledge and Awareness Survey of Adults in Canada, and it showed that 20% of Canadian young adults said they never had even heard of the Holocaust. That must have been disheartening. I'm wondering if we have any newer numbers and what, if anything, has changed in that regard.
I'm not sure if there are any newer numbers at this point in time, but those numbers are very disturbing. I think it points to a broader trend of a real lack of historical knowledge by our young people. This does clearly point to a failure in our education system, more generally speaking, when it comes to teaching history, because if we don't understand the history of where we come from, you know, as you know, they write, we're doomed to repeat it. And it is disheartening because there's been so much time and effort over the years put into, in particular, Holocaust education. But it just means we really need to double down and to take days like this, commemorative days, to let the public know that this is what happens with fascism and when we allow evil to seep into our political system and we completely devalue human life.
And so can you maybe outline some of the measures that are being taken perhaps by B'nai B'rith and other groups to educate young people about the Holocaust and the history?
Well, yes. So first of all, there is Holocaust education. Canada is a member of the International Holocaust Remembrance Alliance, which the country has dedicated itself to fulfilling Holocaust education. This happens at the high school level, although unfortunately it is in a bit of a hodgepodge sort of a way across the country. There are there's so much disinformation that's out there online because of the internet, a lot of Holocaust denial, anti-Semitism. So these are issues that groups such as B'nai B'rith and others are constantly fighting to educate about factual historical background. The Holocaust did happen. Families were destroyed, people were murdered. We need to understand what makes up a proper civil society. And not just use the Holocaust and genocide as a matter of historical background that doesn't have any impact on the modern world or on our current current lives. Hatred still flows. Anti-Semitism still exists. What are we going to do to make sure that this story doesn't repeat itself? Because unfortunately, it is repeating itself over and over again. So human rights groups such as B'nai B'rith were looking very much to both educate based on the historical record, but also make sure that record is not misrepresented, to teach individuals to devalue human life and to hate others because they are identifiably different in some sort of a way, and move forward to fight the modern forces of anti-Semitism and the modern forces of hate to make the world a better place.
And a recent incident of anti-Semitism right here in Canada and in Toronto, the Toronto chapter of the Revolutionary Student Movement. This is, a communist group. They claim they're guided by communist principles, and they tweeted out photos of street art just a few days ago. And the street art consisted of the words Zionism, a paper tiger, freedom for Palestinian students, and freedom for, a Palestinian prisoner. Anyway, death to Zionism was the gist of what this so-called street art had to say. And, you know, distressing that this is happening with young people and even on university campuses.
Absolutely. You're absolutely right. In fact, the name that was written, I believe, on that particular piece of street art, which of course is illegal graffiti, was Ahmed Sadat, who is a terrorist leader for the PFLP, which is a listed terrorist entity in Canada. This particular group claims they're guided. They're Maoist, which is a particular brand of communism. But going into Jewish neighborhoods during the holiday of Passover, and putting this sort of graffiti out, attacking, Zionism, which, you know, they claim is somehow different than Judaism. By the way, the normative way that over 95% of Canadian Jews identify is with identifying through Zionism. And it's very misunderstood. And unfortunately, there are those that try and differentiate and say that I can be an anti-Zionist, right, not an anti-Semite.
Right. Imagine, for example, saying, oh, I love Italians, but I don't think Italy has a right to exist.
Well, exactly. And nobody says that. No, and people quite rightly have problems with communist China today, but I don't hear the conversation, well, you know, China itself should not exist. Countries shouldn't exist. Israel exists. Israel exists. It has a right to exist. And the Jewish community is indigenous to the land of Israel. And that's why, following the horrors of the Holocaust, so many Jews from Europe did go there. But there were many Jews in the Middle East, and there have been Jews living in Israel for thousands of years. So there is an indigenous connection of the Jewish people to the land of Israel. And those that deny it, that is a form of anti-Semitism. And that communist groups, attacks on the Jewish community in Toronto just in the last few days just shows how, just as we need to continue to worry about the forces of fascism and right-wing Nazis and white supremacists, we also still have to worry about hate from the extreme left. And there was no monopoly on hate. It happens on both extremes. And that's why it's so important to keep society sort of more in the center, because we don't want chaos. Chaos is not a good thing when we want to have safety and protection for everybody.
Michael Mostyn, CEO of B'nai B'rith Canada. Michael, thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you so much for having me on.
My pleasure. All right, hour two awaits. News not in the...